The play explores the changing relationship between two individuals and how that's kind of, over time, how that develops and how that changes and how it, I suppose, becomes a problem when they're younger. Their differences are what make them work, and as they get older, it becomes problematic, and it's just that kind of breakdown between them.
So let's just pretend it's a life or death situation.
In what life or death situation would I ever have to make that decision?
Does that really matter?
It's the translation from that relationship that you have when you're a child.
Yeah.
That's incredibly imaginative and free because you don't have any restrictions yet. And it's how that translates into the adult world of having responsibilities and how a relationship is strained as a result.
Or order something, I suppose, but that's expensive.
Come on, answer the question.
Mark, I really don't have time for this.
Come 5 minutes.
I'm serious, I'm stressing out. I really want this to go well.
Mark is a dreamer. Mark has a very strong sense of imagination, and everything he does and everything he thinks is rooted back to this sort of this sense of thinking about things beyond what he can actually see. He won't have a straight conversation, he'll talk about it in terms of these fantasy worlds he creates.
Caroline is incredibly ambitious, I think, not in a detrimental way. When she's younger, I think she's very much in line with Mark. She wants to think about the future. She wants to kind of develop herself. She wants to go places. She wants to succeed. Is I think what she really wants to do. As she gets older, she still wants to do those things, but she becomes a lot more stressed. She has a lot more responsibility.
We're in Hawaii.
Nice choice.
We can feel the soft white sand between our toes. A hot summer sun on our faces.
Mark is a dreamer. His imagination is the thing that Caroline loves about him in Act 1. When they're 16, he takes her off to places. Let's pretend that we're in Hawaii. Let's pretend we're in France. And that is it's exactly the thing that she almost despises about him in the second act.
You can't just pretend our way out of this! This is my fucking life! You can't just pretend that he's not dead because he is.
It's kind of a commentary on taking the world as it is, as opposed to how you wanted it to be when you were young.
It's quite relevant for students, especially first years coming to university and third years approaching leaving university, that idea of once you take that big step, reevaluating your past and your potential future, and whether or not those two kind of line up, and how you've changed and how your relationships with other people have changed.
People should come and see this play because Nikki's writing is fantastic. The work of the actors has been amazing. The set alone is worth it.
Come on. Please, just pretend.
Let's Just Pretend is on from the 4th to the 7th of March with a matinee on the Saturday.